Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Fallout New Vegas, as brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon. As per usual, we're just jumping on in here with some looting. So, it started us out with some basic stuff. It gave us a laser pistol, we got a vault jumpsuit, which I don't care about. Well, I should say we don't care about it, but we have it. We have some stim packs, and miscellaneous stuff, nothing too interesting. Go ahead and hotkey our laser pistol here. Aside from that, you know, we're pretty bare here. One thing I want to check before I do anything. Make sure, yep, got the radio muted because copyright strikes. Arr. So we're going to kind of poke around and steal some stuff. Notably, bottle caps. And that looks like about it. Here, another thing that I want to do because it's going to disorient me is come in here and immersive hood, compass, or not compass, crosshairs. Just flip those always on so that I can actually see. There we go. So we can see where we're pointing. Project Nevada, which is like the big mod that I'm running. I want to say it adds special compasses or crosshairs for weapons, such that they'll actually like show realistically. Screw it. They'll show realistically like what the weapon's bloom is and stuff. So I'm gonna actually pass on this voice modulator implant. This is from Project Nevada. We are not going to take it because this is a little cheaty, grabbing it this early on. Maybe further on down the road. Some anti-venom crutches. Kind of cigarettes, medical braces. I believe we need medical braces to splint limbs. I may be wrong. It's been a while. Today's physician and some reading glasses. So we're going to come in here. We are going to equip the glasses because, damn it, style. I think this is a, yeah. Plus 10 med. I think that's temporary though, but you know, every little bit. Broken submachine gun, I don't think. Yeah, we're not gonna be able to fix this because our repair skill is kind of crappy. Some suspect sunset sarsaparilla, we're gonna take it all because vendor trash. Let's see, chemistry set? Nope. We have no science. And this right here, like these two things, this is why I like this game more than Fallout 3. They actually let you use your skills to do things, and it's interesting, and that will keep up throughout the entire game, and it's just freaking great. All right, let's see if there's anything else worth, I guess, looting here. Not really looking like it. Oh, maybe. No, empty. When we step outside, we're going to get inundated with a lot of pop-ups. See, I'm gonna take the gourd seeds because that's food, and we're gonna need food. We're gonna need water, some ammo. I keep hitting R to take everything. I don't know why. That's from one of their games. I don't remember which one. Nice, another stim pack, some bobby pins. Doc's in his room. Some Abraxo cleaner can just go ahead and stay. Oh, today's physician is worn off. Oh no, I should have probably just sold it. Whatever. Nothing in his oven, his fridge. Has some food we will take. I'm gonna leave the alcohol and stuff behind. Devon is not a drinker. We might start doing drugs again. I know at the end of, I didn't mean to take that yeast, but I did. I know towards the end of, get rid of that, of Fallout 3. He was employing stimulants. We'll just say that. Pre-war relaxware, I don't care. I will take your cigarettes, though. Those are worth money. I love how he just doesn't care. He's like, yeah, no, you can just take everything I own. Not a big deal. I see pre-war books and I'm like, I should take those back to the, not in this one. All right, so let's go ahead and head outside and get on with messages. Like the biggest changes that I made, I'm using pretty much vanilla stuff for all the mods that I'm running. With a couple exceptions. First, blindness. First. Yeah, we got a signal. Yeah. Come on. Let's get this all. Anything else? Yes, no, maybe, no? Alright. So you'll note when I crouch that there is no little detection meter at the top of the screen. That is intentional. I don't want the game to tell me when I'm hiding from everyone. Hey, Gunrunner's Arsenal. Thanks for that. And that's really, I modified the carry weight. The carry weight with Project Nevada, it reduces it substantially. The base carry weight in Fallout is 150. Project Nevada drops it down to 25. I bumped that from 25 to 75. I figured I'd just meet it in the middle. Because I want to be able to carry some stuff. We do get bonus carry weight from our strength, though. And with that, we are in town, and we got all kinds of quests and stuff just rolling in, and I want to essentially ignore them all. I have no idea if I'm going to be doing DLC, and I'm really not even going to entertain the thought over much until we are done with the base game here. So, don't ask. I'm not going to tell. Like how our stats are looking, actually, like our skills, like repair and size, like we're so close, just 2 points off of being able to use that stuff in there. I'm sure we'll pick up a level here. All right, so I gotta remember how things work here. Okay, so we have, oh man, I'm gonna have to swap some hotkeys around here, I think, because I want shift to be run, not sprint. Settings, sprint, no, let's set it to the alt key. So can I like, can I, all right, now I can run with shift and alt lets me do my dash. You got like the bullet time and shit, which I don't know how much I'm gonna use that stuff. I have grenade hotkeys, all kinds of things. We can poke around. Sunny Smiles is in the saloon there. I'm trying to think of like what other mods that I'm adding. I'm running less mods on this Let's Play than I did on my stream Let's Play. I skipped out on pretty much all of the mods that added content to the game that was, I guess, exploratory in nature. So there's no like a World of Pain, no New Vegas bounties and stuff, because I want to kind of just have, I don't want to necessarily say a vanilla experience, but a more vanilla experience. And is there no shadows? But now we've got shadows, they're just minimal, we'll say. Okay, I guess we'll go talk to Sunny Smiles and we'll do the damn tutorial crap. Just get it out of the way. Hey, old man. Easy Pete.
Cheyenne, stay. Don't worry, she won't bite unless I tell her to.
See, I'm trying to think. Here. I think if we ask her this, it's the tutorial, which we don't even remotely need. Actually, I'm a little short on caps. I don't suppose there's any work available?
Not in Good Springs, no. But if you're up for a little scavenging, there's always the schoolhouse. Most of what's in there is junk, but there's this old safe that even Easy Pete wasn't able to crack with dynamite. If you want to take a shot at it, take these.
He couldn't crack it with dynamite because he wasn't running Project Nevada. I am. You can crack safes with dynamite in this and, you know, mini nukes. Magazine on locksmiths.
If the lock's too much for you to handle, reading through the magazine might give you the edge you need.
Alright, I'll go take a look at that safe to see when I have a chance.
Always happy to help someone down on their luck.
Okay, so what do you do around here?
I hunt geckos, mostly. The meat's pretty good and I can always find a buyer for the hides. I also help keep the town clear of rat scorpions and coyotes. Not many people live in Good Springs, so wildlife is always creeping in.
All right, well, goodbye then.
Until next time.
All right, so we have a quest. And there's a little scene, I believe, in here. Oh, no, maybe not. Oh, no, I think that happens later. We'll be back. I'm just going to completely sequence break everything in this. We could try breaking into that. I have a feeling it would fail. Ooh, I'm just going to go ahead and grab those. I've lost karma. Oh, no. We're a bad person in, you know, a world full of bad people. That's okay, not worried. See, this is the shop. The guy in there is a douche because it's like all of Obsidian / Black Isle, like the first towns in them almost always have like the shopkeeper that's an asshole. I mean, he's there, he's a jerk. Icewind Dale, Pomab of Pomab's Emporium is kind of a, you know, dingleberry, which is great. All right, so. God, we have 6 rounds for this thing. We are not equipped, even remotely. Drop rates are lower. Like, Project Nevada is just essentially to make the game harder, which is kind of what I'm in here for. All right, I know there's, Oh, I totally forgot about the freaking camera. Oh my God, it's great. It's the best thing ever. I'm amazing. I hope there's not more than 6 of you little bastards in here. Uh-oh. Oh shit, I missed! Oh fuck! Oh no! Get away from them, they're gonna kill you, dude. There we go, I was gonna say, how do you unequip your weapon? been so long. We're just gonna... Devon's so manly, he can punch giant mantises to death. I'm just running out of, I'd be screaming. I'd just run out of this place screeching and howling. Be terrible. Got a mantis egg, it's worth 12. We'll take it. A locker with absolutely nothing I care about in it. Empty. Some bottle caps. Take all those. Well, there's the safe, obvious though it is. We should be able to, yeah, as I say, we should be able to get into this with, like, no trouble whatsoever. He says, moments before breaking all of his lockpicks. So bottle caps, a cybernetic surgery magazine. Well, not really useful in our hands. With this highly educational and particularly rare book, every decent doctor should be able to learn the art of cybernetic surgery. Okay. A super stim pack, a stealth boy, some pre-war money, and some mentats. You can also, I believe, get into this thing by hacking this computer. Programmer's Digest. I wish programming worked like that in real life. You know, you just read a magazine and all of a sudden you're, you know, a super genius. Pro tip, guys, it doesn't work like that in real life. Just saying. See, another Programmer's Digest. There's just all over the place. Nothing and nothing. Salesman Weekly. I'm only taking them because they're worth a little bit of money. I'm not going to use them. I'm ready for more mantises in here. My fists are aching to punish evil insects. Tin can, box of detergent, a broom. All right, and a cherry bomb. Nope. There is crafting in this, and I think you use like... I think it's cherry bombs and a lunchbox and bottle caps. And you can make bottle cap mines, which are like one of the deadliest things in the freaking game. It's ridiculous. Nothing there. I do want to say... Oh, this begins me jumping everywhere again. See, I want to say... Oh, we got some jalapenos. That's not what I'm looking for. Did we actually get sent over here by somebody to pick some plants or something? Can't remember. I think it's these Xander roots. Just gonna grab those. I don't know how many of them I need. Ideally, it's, you know, two or fewer. Let's go harass Sunny some more. Tell her we got into that safe and, you know, did things that adventurers do. We really should go through her tutorial crap because it's gonna open up missions for us and stuff, and we're gonna need it. So I'm gonna hate my life a little bit, but whatever. I see those, I think those are musk oxes. I see those things and I want to call them muffalos, and muffalos are from Rimworld, and they're essentially just giant buffaloes. Okay. Hey, I cleared out your thing.
Hi there, sticking around Good Springs for a while longer?
Okay, you don't even care. All right, so yeah, Dr. Mitchell said you could teach me to survive in the desert, and I'm helpless.
Yeah, I guess there's a thing or two I could show you. Sounds like you need all the help you can get after what they done to you. Meet me outside, behind the saloon.
You wanna see my scars? That's right, leave the room. Is there anything else worth stealing in here? Probably not. See, door. Alright, no. Okay, let's just, where are you? I know you got bottles you want me to shoot.
Now, see the sarsaparilla bottles on the fence there? Take this and try to hit a couple of them. That's the right idea. Try crouching down and... Nice shot. Well, that's a start. But I don't reckon you came to me to learn to fight sarsaparilla bottles.
Nope.
Tell you what, I gotta go chase geckos away from our water supply anyway. Darn critters are attracted to it. Why don't you come along?
Sure, I'm in.
Follow me. It's just down to the southeast a short ways.
You can't see it, but my soul is just slowly dying. I'm gonna quick save. I fear, like, it's a Bethesda game. Bethesda. I'm sure people are going to be whinging in the comments about my pronunciation of the development or the publisher. I don't care, though. You guys aren't here for proper wording or competency. You're here to watch me fail and bitch about it. Anyways, I'm sure we are all well aware of their game's penchant for crashing about, you know, every 15 minutes when you're running them with mods, or if you're the Skyrim Special Edition that just recently released, you know, right after you leave the tutorial dungeon. I got hit by that. Got a whopping, you know, 10 minutes of play in before the game died on me. Completely unmodded. High quality entertainment, folks. I think that's coming out on the Switch, isn't it? I'm just waiting for the phone version. You know it's coming. So, I guess the upside to this gun is at least now we have some ammo? Well, I shouldn't say that we have ammo, but now we have a gun with ammo. We've had ammo all along. Alright, so the geckos are up here. They're probably, like, rolling around, pooping in the water, and, you know, need bullets. So I'm gonna go ahead and crouch and see if we can see a... Yep! Oh! Oh, there's another one to his left. Thanks, Sniper Cam! Go ahead and flip my mouse sensitivity down so I can aim here. Alas, this game... Oh, come on. Unless this game does not allow you to set separate sensitivities based on whether or not you're free-looking or aiming down the sights. Come on. There we go. I was probably hitting him, but we're not gonna get sneak attack damage when they're out of range like that. All right, well, I dropped two of them and we killed all of them. So, hey, Sunny, what's up?
See, you're getting the hang of it. There's two more wells that still need clearing. You want, you can come along. It'd be worth a few caps to me.
Yeah, it should be. I'm doing all your work for you.
Shouldn't take more than a couple minutes, especially with two of us. Come with me.
Freaking gave me 60 rounds. Okay. Ammo's gonna be, like, I shouldn't say incredibly hard to come by, but much harder to come by than in the base game. It'll probably be very much a Fallout 3 situation where I'm going to be depending on a lot of different kinds of guns because I'm not gonna have ammo necessarily for what I want to use at all times. Where are you, little shits? Ah! Fuck, my aim! Oh! Right in the head meats! I saw tongue. Shit, the dog! Esports. You just put a bullet into your dog, lady? That's dark. Where'd you... What is she doing? Wait up! Wait up, wait up, wait up! I'm slow and easily frightened. Okay, I'm with you. Where are we going? Other well, other well. Oh, that's right, I totally forgot about this chick getting eaten alive.
Come on.
There we go. I shot it in the butt, guys. It worked. All right, look at that experience point ticker slowly going up. Yeah, that was all me, I don't mean to brag. You're welcome.
Holy moly. If you hadn't come here like you done, I'd be a goner for sure. I came up here to draw water, but here, you should have what I got. You look thirsty.
So thirsty. Yeah, reputation. Pro tip, you can make friends if you're not a dick. It's helpful. All right, so we got some water out of that. Geckos have nothing, naturally. I suppose that's fair. All right, Sunny, we done?
Now that was some good work. Even got a little exciting there at the end. Here's a little spending money for the trouble. One more thing I wanted to show you. Thought I might teach you about living off the land and making useful things for yourself. Interested?
Sure, couldn't hurt.
All right, then. We'll need a couple ingredients to get started. Gonna want some Xander root and a Brock flower. Let me think now. I know I've seen Brock flowers growing up at the graveyard, and I seem to remember there being Xander root over by the schoolhouse. Bring those on back to me, and we'll get cooking.
All right, well, I thought I had everything that I needed, but naturally I didn't. We gotta go up to the graveyard, which might be right up there. I could do the smart thing, I guess, and pull up my map. Yeah, that's pretty much where I thought it was. All right, let's do this. We have a little compass thing on our compass down there. I purposefully have the compass kind of low so that I kind of am more able to ignore quest markers, because... Like, I don't mind, like, if they're gonna show me where a quest is on the world map, that's one thing, but the little quest markers and stuff on the compass, it's A little much. Now, I believe on our way up here, we're gonna have to watch out for a bark scorpion, which, true to real life, they're tiny and generally pretty innocuous, but if one of them stings you, you're gonna have a bad time. All right, so I wanna say that's actually the graveyard right there. I see a wolf out there, coyote. So, I mean, I'm gonna put a bullet into it because we've got to. It's experience points and we're halfway near leveling. All right, here, well, that's there. So now it'll stop freaking harassing me about it. Look at those hit chances. I like my odds of doing it like this better. Because I'm just gonna aim for center of mass, and hey, look at that. The system works. All right, 5 experience points. Easy gun jammed there because it's damaged, but there's not a whole heck of a lot we can do about that. Let's see, I wanna say if we wander, I think it's if we wander that way too far, there's death claws. And if we wander this way too far, there's cazadors, which in my mind are substantially worse than death claws. They're like killer bees on some form of opiate in addition to steroids. They're just really nasty. All right, so that little bastard should be floating up here somewhere. He's normally up on the side of the road up here. Yep, there he is. Yes, but I think it's got like one hit point or something. Like, yeah, it's not a threat at all as long as you don't get into melee with it. All right, game, we get it. It's dead camera. There we go. All right, one experience point. Look at that, it's so valuable. Is that everything? Sounds like it's everything. Can we get a poison gland off of you, maybe? Oh yeah, look at that, it's worth 35. So what I'm probably gonna do is finish this quest and then we're gonna call it, and this'll just be, you know, ye oldie tutorial level that everybody has to watch and be miserable about at the beginning of the Let's Play. Sorry, guys. Oh shit, blowflies, I forgot about you. My aim is true, and by true I mean hot trash. Yeah, hit once. Oh. So wait. Is that thing weird? All right, it landed apparently. That, okay. We got, oh my God, my aim. I'd be better off just running up and punching the damn things. Oh God, terrifying, they're breeding. Oh my God, just, we'll just do it like this. Hey, blowfly. Hey, buddy. Hey, what are you doing, just hanging out? Hold still for a second. Also, all right. Hey, I hit it. It didn't freaking kill. Oh my God. Shoot the thing point blank. No bueno. At least no kill, I should say. There we go. All right. Now, this is what I want. As I say, there should be a snow globe. There are a bunch of these throughout the world. And this is true. Some collectors will, in fact, pay dearly for them. One collector in particular. All right, so let's see, keep out. And this is where I was, you know, nice and buried there. I think it's Z, yeah, come here, bullet fly. Ah, you're stuck in the ground, damn it. I was gonna throw it in the grave. Words are hard. I think we can dig these up, can't we? Yeah, but we need a shovel. Oh, there's gotta be a shovel floating around here. Devon is not like above defiling the graves of the dead. Seriously, there's like no shovel. Oh, keep out. I wonder if I can, I'm on quick save, just in case. See if I can get an eye on. We are finished. That is the, hey, you're leaving Noob Town. And if you want, you can have a chance to rebuild your character. Now, one thing that this game does that Fallout 3 does not do, and I have to give Bethesda credit, this game loves invisible walls, and I guarantee you guys I'm going to be throwing bitch fits the likes of which you have never seen. All right, that right there, those are cazadors, and I bet one of those things could hit me once and kill me. It's not necessarily their initial attack that kills you, it's the poison that they hit you with. It is just stupidly lethal, and even like late game, they're just really nasty. All right, so what was up here for? I totally forgot. Xander root, Brock flowers, alright. Which I think are these? No. Some tobacco, prickly pear. Well, I mean, I'm gonna take the fruit because I need food. The chew can stick around. It's a brock flower. What the hell's a brock flower look like? I don't know! 20 minutes later, he finally figures out, oh, it's the giant flowering thing that he's been walking circles around probably this entire time. It's not this, is it? No. Okay. And it's not these. I thought it was these. Let me check some real quick. Nope. Alright, just making sure that it's not like an interactable that's just bugged or something. Yeah, I don't know. Unless it's under the water tower, which could be the case. But I'm not seeing it. There's more keep out. There, we've got some rad scorpions. These, I might be able to kill them, but it's not even remotely going to be worth the expenditure. Oh, is this a brock flower right here? Yes, all right. So they're little sticks, and there was one. All right, back to Sunny. Can we fast travel there by any chance? This game does have fast travel. Oh, thank you for that. That sweet little mercy of not making me run my happy ass back here just to complete the damn tutorial. All right, where's Sunny? Yeah, there she is. Let's go ahead and put our gun away. You move faster when you don't have your gun out. Not much, but a little bit. Aha! All the hunt is on. Those roving experience points are mine, wench! No, dog! You stole my experience points. There's only one way to get them back. Oh, my vittles are chapped.
Let me see what you got. Yeah, these'll do just fine. Just fine. All right now, we're gonna be making something folks on the trail call healing powder. Go on over to that campfire now. Give it a try.
Yeah, this is where the survival skill comes in. You can do all kinds of, like, you can see here, there's just a crap load of stuff you can make. And it all has various requirements, like you can see this is, you know, survival and hides and stuff. And then you can make like your own armor and stuff. It's crazy. It's pretty cool. I like it. So we're gonna make some healing powder.
Hey, that's not bad, see? All it takes to make a recipe is the right ingredients and the right know-how. Sometimes it won't be a campfire you need. Might need to do some work on your guns and ammo, maybe. Important thing to get is it's all the same idea. You just need to find the right place to set up shop. Workbench or reloading bench, whatever. Well, I hope that's enough to get you started. I'm heading back now. Hope I didn't miss anything good on the jukebox. Cheyenne would never forgive me. Hey, do me a favor. Trudy, she's the bartender up at the Prospector. Kind of the town mom. She likes to meet newcomers. She'd be cross with me if I didn't ask you to poke your head in and say hi.
Alright, so that will essentially be where we are going to be starting next time. I don't know, are they going to give us XP for completing this quest? No, alas. I did, however, I believe, see another little red dit out here. I'm going to go ahead and poke my nose up a little bit, see if we can't see any interesting sights. Ah, you little bastard, I see you. Ah! Ooh, here we go. Let's say I should be able to kill one of them because that critical hit damage multiplier is just perfect. Oh my god. Oh, crippled its head and down it goes. All right. Ending on 10 experience points. I'll take it. We've got 60 rounds left for our rifle. No energy ammo, but we'll be able to ideally buy some. We'll probably do some shopping, a little more questing next time, and then eventually we'll be headed out there, but not for a little while. I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I had a good time, and I will see you all next time when the adventure continues. Until then.